The problem with Kenyans is that sometimes they don't look at the history of people. Ababu was born in 1975 in Uganda. And I don't even want to go about the fact that now he's Kenyan. I am saying on JFK.
Come on.
I am telling you now, Ababu was born in Uganda.
So he and Matsanga are sort of a...
No, I don't want to speak about somebody else other than the one you've asked me about. Number one. Number two, he went to an election to be elected in Kasarani. There was chaos and destruction at Kasarani. Mm. They could not elect because they said there were men in black. Ababu Namwamba and his party partners conspired to blackmail themselves into leadership of the Orange Democratic Movement. Ababu Namwamba has never been elected by any member of ODM to be Secretary General. I also want to tell you something about his constituency, Budalangi. Mm. Half of his Budalangi constituency is from Luo Nyanza. There's even a place I've had fish with the retired Prime Minister called Omena Beach. And Ababu Namwamba cannot be an MP without ODM. He does not represent either his community, the Luhya people. From now, what I understand, he doesn't represent the Prime Minister who he taped in secret. And the members of his own committee. And the rules of parliament are very clear. The only way to remove a chairman elected to stand in a party or by party to a standing committee of parliament is by more than 50% of the vote.
Okay, Tony,
he has 23 members, Jeff. Mm. 13 voted against them, and 9 voted for him. Others abstained. And you may wonder why they abstained. But the question is, a man who doesn't have, one, the confidence of his party leader, he doesn't have a mandate because he's not elected. He's a hostage of ODM because his constituency is half ODM. And a man who is today writing to the speaker and accusing his members who have lost confidence in him.